Hello friends, good day to all. Today we have come with another important new topic, that is the spermatogenesis. This is the part of male reproductive system. So with this, let us proceed. My dear friends, whenever we come across any words, the easy and simple way of learning this is to split these words and separately take the meaning. So here, what is the meaning of genesis? Here, genesis means the formation, the process of formation. So at the same time, this word is derived from the sperm. Sperm is the male gamete. So now you have combined this meaning. It is the process of formation of male gamete, that is sperm. So it is very easy to understand like this. So my dear friends, the first question arises here is, what is the site of spermatogenesis and what is the source from these sperms are being produced? My dear friends, if you have gone through my previous video, I have very clearly made you understand the concept of spermatogenesis, that is arising from the testis. So testis, the site is actually, we have discussed, the organ is the reproductive organ, that is a primary sexual organ. Because primary sexual organs, characteristic feature is that they are only gamete producing organs. So in case of males, it is the testis. But to be specific, we also have learned that is the spermatogenesis is occurring in the seminiferous tubules. So now we are going to learn how in these seminiferous tubules is spermatogenesis is occurring. So now the question arises, what is the source in the seminiferous tubule from which these spermatozoa are being formed? The answer is very simple. We have already learned, that is the spermatogonium. All these sperms are being produced basically from these by many cell division process. Different cell divisions can be mitosis or meiosis and leading to the formation of sperm. So this is also known as the spermatogonium mother cells or spermatogonium stem cells. So this is how we have to correlate and learn the nomenclature as well. So my dear friends, let us go now into the actual what is a flow chart, and so that we can understand better. So my dear friends, as you all are seeing here, this is the seminiferous tubule. So if you take the section of seminiferous tubule and enlarge, so this is how it is. So the inner part, this is the lumen, and this is all the lining epithelium. And here there are two types of cells in the seminiferous tubules generally, and in relation to the seminiferous tubules there are three type of cells, but here there are two type of cells, because here generally it is lined by what? Seminiferous tubule is lined by germinal epithelial tissue, and this germinal epithelial tissue will be having spermatogonium. So this is all how it is arranged. So this will be having the spermatogonium cells, and this is lined by the germinal epithelium, and germinal epithelium will having spermatogonial cells. And to be specific, there are some another Sertoli cells. They are helping cells or the nerve cells, and we'll be discussing in detail next. So here in the context, let us proceed how the spermatogonial cells are forming the spermatozoa. So here, as you are seeing, the resting spermatogonium cells will undergo many cycles of mitosis, cell division, and form the type A and type B spermatogonium cells. And what is important to note here is that type A cells will be reverted back in the cycle, whereas only type B cells are proceeding forward in the spermatocytosis. So here the type B cells are undergoing another mitosis division and forming the primary spermatocyte, primary spermatocyte. Up to here only mitosis division is taking place, mitosis division is taking place. But from the primary spermatocyte, the meiosis division starts, because here the primary spermatocyte undergo meiosis 1 and form the secondary spermatocyte. As we all know, if you have at least a bit of knowledge about the difference between the meiosis and mitosis, you will understand that this meiosis is known as the reduction type of division. That is the reason why here the chromosome number is reduced to half. So it has formed a secondary spermatocyte, and this secondary spermatocyte undergo meiosis division 2, meiosis 2, and lead to the formation of spermatids, So my dear friends, now next what is happening is you have to analyze here that in the next process the number of what spermatids are not increasing. So here are 4 and here also 4. So both are number is 4. Here when you see it is 1 and forming 2. So here it is 1 and forming 2. So all these process are division process. Whereas here, as the number count is same in both, so there is no cell division here. Whereas then the question arises, what is happening that is making the spermatids to spermatozoa, and what is the special name for this process under the spermatogenesis? It is also a part of spermatogenesis, but we have named a special name for this process because here there is no division, as well as there is also a changes in the form of the cells. So this changes of form in the cell is known as metamorphosis. So the metamorphosis, the process of metamorphosis that is leading spermatids to spermatozoa, this is known as the spermiogenesis. Now let us move to our next slide so that we can understand more in a better process. Before that, I would like to stress one point that here, as you are seeing, the lining epithelium is giving the spermatogonium, and this slowly as there is a division taking place, they are moving towards the lumen, so that at the end of the process these spermatozoa formed can be easily released into the lumen. And for your kind information, the releasing of spermatozoa, mature spermatozoa into the lumen is known as spermiation. This is very important. This is spermiogenesis and this is spermiation. So this is all the terminology. Generally students get confused, but I will explain in detail in another slide as well. So don't confuse. For this slide, you just remember that these cells are, as they are dividing by any means, mitosis or meiosis, they are moving towards the lumen so that they can be released into the lumen very easily at the end. So after releasing into the lumen, how they are passed outside the body via different ducts, I have clearly given all the idea and the concept in previous class. Please go and watch. So let us move to our next slide. So my dear friends, in this slide you can see very clearly here that how we have differentiated meiosis, spermiogenesis and spermatocytosis. My dear friends, this 1, 2 and 3, all these are part of spermatogenesis only. All these three come under the, these are spermatogenesis. So all these are just the parts of spermatogenesis only. So don't get confused. So here in the spermatogenesis only, up to the primary spermatocytes, as there is only mitosis taking place, so this is named separately as a spermatocytosis. Whereas this primary spermatocyte to conversion of secondary and secondary to spermatids, all this is under the meiosis. And third stage is the metamorphosis stage, that is from spermatids to the spermatozoa. This is spermiogenesis. Whereas the release of spermatozoon into the lumen, that process is known as spermiation. That process is known as spermiation. Now I would like to bring to your notice that how these number of chromosomes are being reduced and changed along the process. And I will also discuss what is the difference between small and capital N. So if you write small n and if you write capital N, what is the difference? So here small n is changing. So my dear friends, spermatogonium also has 2n, all these has 2n, and up to primary spermatocyte all has 2n. And as soon as this meiosis 1 takes place, the number is reduced to half. So and all these are n. So here what we have to note that due to this meiosis 1, that is the reduction division, what we call sperm count has been halved. Whereas here in meiosis 2, the sperm count has not halved. Why? Because if you go in depth and learn what is meiosis, you will definitely put one point that meiosis 2 is similar to mitosis. That is the reason why there is no reduction of chromosome number. Then what is the meaning? What does indicate capital N? Capital N indicates the amount of DNA in the cell. So this is the important topic usually asked in MCQs, and also many students get confused and neglect these points. So please don't do that. So my dear friends, we have completed all the things. Let us move to the next and try to learn the spermiogenesis process in depth. As we all know that in the process of spermiogenesis, that is a part of spermatogenesis only. In the spermiogenesis, there is no cell division occurring either in neither mitosis nor meiosis. So only metamorphosis is occurring, and in this metamorphosis, the spermatids are transformed by changing in the form, by bringing changes in the form from spermatid to spermatozoa. So what are all those forms? What are changes taking place in its form, shape or form? So well, let us see all those things. So here you can see very clearly that this spermatids, how it is transformed into mature spermatozoa, how these Golgi apparatus and this nucleus, these centrioles and the mitochondrions are being changed into another forms. So first, if you see, this Golgi apparatus is changed into the acrosomal cap, that is covering two-thirds of the nucleus anteriorly. So and this nucleus has condensed and moved towards anterior pole. So how this nucleus has condensed and moved towards anterior pole. At the same time, you can also appreciate this centrosome is divided into proximal and the distal centrioles, and proximal is forming the axial filament, and that is lying in the neck region, whereas the distal will be present here in the middle, at the junction of the middle piece and the tail. So apart from this, you can also see here that how mitochondria has developed into a spiral sheet that is covering the encircling around the axial filaments to form the middle piece of the spermatozoa. Whereas we also have to know one more thing, that the cytoplasm has shaded into a residual body known as the Raynaud's residual body. All these 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. All these are the changes that are occurring during the process of spermiogenesis. Whereas the release of spermatozoa into the lumen is known as the process of spermiation. You have to differentiate these two processes and do not get confused. After knowing all this, if you study in a conceptual manner, definitely you are not going to confuse.